Hi there. With this video, what we're going to do is we're going to take the portable example that comes in the SimpleLink SDKs for the CC3220 and move that same functionality to an MSP432, a CC2640R2, a CC1310, and a CC1350. And what we're going to do is we're just going to take 100% of the source code from portable, drop them into some empty templates for the other launch pads, build it, and run it. Okay, here we are at TI Resource Explorer at dev.ti.com. So I'm going to import in an MSP432 empty example, basically the template that we saw on the previous slide. So let me go down to examples. Here's for the launch pad. Let's go down to TI drivers. Here's empty. We could use FreeRTOS, but we're going to use the TRTOS one, and then we'll use the CCS compiler one. So I'm going to import this into CCS Cloud. I've already imported the other empties. I don't think anybody wanted to watch me do a lot of button clicks. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the source files from portable application source files and move them into each one of these. So first of all, I'm going to delete the application source files and the README from all these examples. Actually, this is probably the slowest part of the whole lab. Delete this one. I'm just hitting the delete button here. And finally, for the last one here, we'll delete those same application source files. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take the application source files from the portable for the CC3220, and I'm going to copy those, and I'll copy the READMEs also because we want to get those updated. So I'm going to copy these. I'm going to paste these in each one of here, each one of the applications. So paste, first one's ported, next one's ported, ported, ported. So we've ported portable to each one of these different launch pads now. Now I'm going to go through and actually build one of these to make sure that we don't get compile errors or warnings, that we're not doing any tricks here. And there's the first one built. Let's build the next one. And actually, when I build the MSP432 one, I'm actually going to run it and show it working also. R2 board built, and finally we'll go for the MSP432. So let's build that one. And as you notice, I don't know if you can see it, scrolling by, again, no compiler warnings or anything. So let's go ahead and debug this one. I have a launch pad hooked up. So it's initializing everything here. Pretty soon it's going to be initializing the flash. And there we go. We're in main. So I'm going to go ahead and run now. And this application, if you had opened it up and looked at the README in here, you would see how to use this example. And we try to include READMEs in all the examples. On this one, it's going to use a serial port, so let's connect the, oops, I already had it connected. Let's connect the COM port. As you can see from the README, we need to take it up to a faster baud rate. So now we have a console here. And if I type in T, that's just going to get me the current temperature. So I'm going to point my MSP432 with a sensors booster pack. And actually, you could see it here in the README. It uses a sensors booster pack. I'm going to point that at my coffee mug. And we should see the temperature start to rise here. And there we go. So the application is working. And the temperature sensor is just read via an I2C. So how was all this possible? How were we able to port this example over so easily? Well, let's take a look at one of the source files here. And really, it comes down to the TI drivers. So here, this UART-write. That UART-write is applicable for all the SimpleLink SDK devices. So you don't have to change any application code to move to a different UART. Similarly, if you wanted to be able to port across different OSs, this is using POSIX. SimPost is a POSIX call. POSIX is a abstraction for different operating systems. You're not required to use it, but if you do want to use it with the SimpleLink SDKs, it gives you a nice OS portability so you can move between FreeRTOS and TRRTOS very easily. For those that notice these projects down here, these are the kernel projects associated with these examples. we open one of these up, you'll see the TRTOS configuration file. The CFG can be in the project or it can be its own project. This one, it's kind of nice because it allows portability between FreeRTOS and TRTOS very easily, because basically you just depend on different kernel projects. It also allows you to move between a like a debug versus a release kernel configuration very easily. This lab is actually detailed in our SimpleLink Academy, which is part of the SimpleLink SDKs. So if we went down here under in the labs for TI drivers, porting TI drivers. So here are all the steps that we did. This was the main step. Basically, we removed files and then added new ones. There's things to consider when you're porting, and these steps talk about each one. What happens if you change the kernel configuration? What happens if you added additional UARTs in your board files? What happens if you change project settings? So this kind of details what steps you need to do. And then at the end, there's even a quiz. So does every SimpleLink device have TI driver support? Of course it does. And with SimpleLink Academy, it's kind of nice. Also, even if you answer incorrectly, we'll guide you and let you know that you're wrong. So I hope you enjoyed, let me finish on a positive note there. I hope you enjoyed this presentation and see how easy it is to move your application code from one device to another SimpleLink device with just a few clicks.